Hello everyone, how's it going? In this video, let's have a look at the .os or Droid on Time ROM for the LG V30. As you can see here, this is based out of Android 11 and this has the July 5th, 2021 Android patch level. And this is the 5.1.2 version and this is the latest as of now. And I'm using it on my H930DS, but you can use it on any LG V30 variant. So let's have a look at the features that this ROM offers. So first of all, these are the quick settings, and if you pull down on the notification shade, you get these quick toggles as well as option for editing and the setting shortcut. And as you can see here, there are several options here: NFC, AOD, stuff like that. And you also have the hi-fi quad DAC tile, so that's pretty cool. Let's go back, and under system settings we have gestures. So you have the gesture to quickly open camera. You have system navigation gestures. So that's pretty cool. And these are the customizations that you have. They are fewer than the ones that we find on other ROMs, but well, this is a pretty lean ROM. And as you can see here, there are some power menu options, device controls, and some other stuff. Now let's move on. Here is the status bar tuner, and here you can customize the icons that can be shown here. Do note that Volte does not work on any AOSP ROM, and this is just a toggle that is present within the ROM. It does not do anything as such, so there's no Volte. And you can customize to always show percentage or don't show, but this, as you can see, did nothing much because they are based in other settings. And if you go under accessibility settings and you go down, you have some other options like mono audio and this kind of stuff. These are some general settings, as you can see here, nothing much here. And you could customize the display size, etc., from there. And as you move up, this is here where you find the customization settings. But first, let's go into the display section. And here you have a dark theme toggle, and you also have styles and wallpapers settings here. So that's pretty cool. As you can see here, you can customize these a lot. And you can even create custom fonts, styles, and change around, mess with this stuff, and choose icon shape, that kind of stuff. And you can name this. Now let us go back, but before that, here is where you can always show time and date info, time and other info on the lock screen. And this is the customization settings. Here you have wallpaper options, and as you can see here, there are a lot of, not really a lot, but four built-in wallpapers. And here is the AOD customization. Here you can enable and disable it. And there's also an option for edge lighting, which is pretty cool. It pulses the AOD from the sides when you get a notification. And here you can customize it. And here is the custom color option. As you can see, you can choose any color virtually. And here are the status bar options, as you can see. So I'll quickly go through these features. And as you can see, I have enabled the percentage for the battery here. That's why it not nothing in the other setting. And you can customize where you want to place the clock. So you just drag and swipe left and right. That's how you change this. You have the option to show clock, not to show clock, percentage style, that kind of stuff. And I'll just quickly show you these options. You can read about them. I'll not talk about all of them individually. Now, talking about the performance on this ROM has been great, and I tried PUBG Mobile on this particular ROM and it worked great. And you could easily get about 3 hours of playtime. And I used the low plus extreme FPS settings, and I was able to hit on average about 55 FPS on average. But as you play more, the device heats up and the FPS will drop. But for about 2 games, you should be able to maintain an FPS above 55 FPS. So that's pretty cool. And here was the app lock option. As you can see here, This is pretty nifty. You can lock up the apps that you want, but I don't want to, so I'll just unlock that. And here is the lab, as you can see. So there is a lot of customization in this particular room, and you can even customize the clock face that you have, the Samsung one. And as you can see here, there are so many options. So this is just a code. I don't think I like that, so I'll just make it the shapeshifter or whatever that option is. Yeah, buttons. And battery life has been also pretty decent, but do note that I'll place the link to this room in the description below, and avoid the Google Apps inbuilt version because that has been providing a lot of issues and bugs for several people, which is not present on the non-G Apps version. So I would totally recommend that you go with non-G Apps version, and I'm using Nick G Apps core with it, but you could probably use any of them. Just avoid the inbuilt G Apps version. There are a few theming options, as you can see here. So there are a lot of themes creation kind of a stuff. As you can see here, you can change the font, etc. Overall, this is a very well balanced room, and it is pretty up to date, and I'm loving this particular room. And let me quickly show you the gestures here. As you can see here, double tap to sleep, double tap to wake for torch, all that kind of nifty stuff. And this is the launcher here. As you can see here, you have some setting options. And as you can see here, at a glance, home screen rotation. So that's pretty much it for this video. If you liked it, click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel for more such videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye bye. And make sure to read all the bugs and FAQ fixes, etc., that I'll be linking down in the description below. Bye bye now.